Hey, you can start now. So everybody, welcome to this week's PNS Tremulator course. Today, Christina will be presenting a paper named Synchron, which was published last year. So Christina, please start when you're ready.
Thank you for the introduction. In this talk, I will discuss about efficient hardware synchronization mechanism in modern computing systems, and I will mainly emphasize on near data processing architectures. And more specifically, I will present our work called Synchron, who was published at HPCA the last year. And it provides the first end-to-end hardware synchronization solution for near data processing architectures. We will start with the motivation of this work, and some recent studies have greatly renewed interest in near data processing or NDP. NDP architectures can improve performance and energy efficiency of a computing system by moving computation closer to the data and reducing data movement. Therefore, these NDP architectures are quite attractive for a wide range of application domains, including graph analytics, neural networks, recommendation systems, and bioinformatics. At the same time, synchronization primitives such as locks and barriers are widely used in many emerging multi-threaded applications, and examples of such applications are graph analytics, image processing, databases, and concurrent data structures. All of these applications are very irregular, and they are typically bottlenecked by memory, and therefore they constitute a very good fit for near data processing architecture. However, to fully leverage the benefits of near data processing systems for these parallel applications, an effective synchronization solution is necessary. In our work, we identify three important characteristics that necessitate a new approach to support efficient synchronization in NDP systems. Specifically, supporting synchronization in NDP systems is challenging because NDP architectures lack shared caches among NDP cores of the system, and thereby synchronization would need to be implemented via main memory, however, with a great penalty in performance and energy. NDP systems also lack hardware cache coherence support, and the communication across the NDP units of the system is quite expensive. To this end, we have designed Synchron, which is the first end-to-end synchronization solution for NDP architectures. Synchron provides high system performance and carries very low hardware and area cost. It is easy to use, programmer-friendly, and generally supports a wide range of synchronization primitives to cover a variety of emerging applications. So we will first examine the solution space for synchronization in NDP systems. So let's start with the baseline NDP architecture that we assume in this work. Typical NDP architectures support several NDP units connected to each other, with each unit comprising multiple NDP cores close to main memory. Therefore, these NDP architectures provide high levels of parallelism, low memory access latency, and large aggregated memory bandwidth. We identify three important characteristics that necessitate a new approach to support efficient synchronization in NDP systems. First, typical NDP architectures do not support conventional hardware cache coherence protocols due to their high area and traffic overhead. Second, NDP systems are typically non-uniform and distributed, in which the inter-unit communication is quite expensive. And third, most NDP architectures lack shared caches because NDP-suited workloads do not typically benefit from deep cache hierarchy due to their poor cache locality, and therefore we cannot enable a very low-cost communication and synchronization among NDP cores of the system by leveraging a shared level of cache memory. So let's examine the solution space for synchronization. Synchronization means communication. Cores need to communicate with each other and coordinate with each other in order to reach an agreement. We find that approaches to support synchronization are typically of two types. via shared memory and via message passing schemes. In the first approach, cores coordinate among them via a consistent view of shared memory locations, and more specifically, they use atomic read, modify, write operations supported by hardware in order to modify shared memory locations and communicate information with each other and coordinate. In the second approach, cores communicate with each other by exchanging messages, either in the software or in the hardware level, in order to reach an agreement. Both shared memory approach and message passing approach for synchronization are implemented through various mechanisms. In this work, we have examined many prior synchronization schemes that have been proposed in the literature, and we discuss how they could be applied in NDP system and if they would constitute a good fit for NDP architecture. We classify those prior schemes in different groups. First, in commodity systems like CPUs and some massively parallel processing systems, synchronization is implemented via the underlying hardware cache coherence protocols, which, however, most near data processing systems do not support. And therefore, the coherence-based synchronization primitives the typical approach for synchronization in CPU systems, cannot be directly applied in NDP systems because they do not support the conventional hardware cache coherence protocols. Then we find that synchronization in GPUs and some massively parallel processing systems can be implemented using remote atomics. These remote atomics are dedicated hardware units that provide atomic read, modify, write operations. However, these remote atomics can also be found in many other systems. However, this approach is oblivious to the non-uniformity of an NDP system. Therefore, these schemes would cause excessive expensive traffic across the NDP units of the system with significant performance and energy overheads, and therefore they do not constitute a very good fit for NDP systems. Furthermore, we have found that there are prior hardware synchronization schemes, mechanisms proposed in the literature, which are built upon a shared level of cache memory. However, NDP architectures do not support, do not include the shared level of cache memory, and therefore these prior synchronization schemes would need to be implemented using main memory, however, incurring high hardware costs. And finally, we find that there are some recent NDP works that propose software-based message passing schemes that can be applied in NDP systems. These approaches typically include dedicated NDP cores that handle synchronization requests through their memory hierarchy. And as we demonstrate in our evaluation, even though these approaches can be applied in NDP systems, they are still quite inefficient and they provide low performance benefits. Overall, we find that these prior synchronization solutions that have been proposed are not suitable or they are not very efficient for NDP architecture. And to this end, we have designed our approach, which is called Synchron, building on the message passing synchronization concept in order to avoid major issues of synchronization via shared memory approach. Specifically, in NDP system, synchronization via a shared memory approach would need to be implemented using main memory, however, with a great penalty for performance and energy. Therefore, we build Synchron using a hardware message passing synchronization concept. Synchron also eliminates the expensive traffic across the NDP units of the system by implementing a hierarchical synchronization scheme. We prioritize the intra-unit communication and deprioritize the inter-unit communication in order to avoid expensive network traffic. And finally, Synchron avoids using main memory to access synchronization variables by buffering all of these variables to a specialized cache memory structure in order to minimize the latency cost. So let's now take a look on the details of Synchron and Synchron's design. Synchron consists of four key techniques that I will describe next in more detail. First, we design low-cost hardware units, which are called synchronization engines, and they are located at each NDP unit of the system in order to coordinate synchronization among NDP cores. NDP cores communicate their requests using two new ISA instructions, the RecSync and the RecAsync. These ISA instructions are used to assemble a message that is sent from an NDP core to the synchronization engine through the network and communicates necessary information from the software to the hardware. A synchronization engine includes the synchronization processing unit, which in turn includes a few registers, a small buffer, and the control logic to encode and decode the message. Using these specialized synchronization engines, we avoid the need for complex cache coherent protocols, expensive atomic operations, and as we will later see, those specialized hardware units have very low area and power costs. Second, we add a specialized cache memory structure, the synchronization table, inside each synchronization engine in order to keep the necessary information needed to coordinate synchronization. When a synchronization engine receives a request from an NDP core for a particular synchronization variable, the synchronization processing unit processes the message and directly buffers the request to the synchronization table, keeping all the information needed for synchronization locally. And with the direct buffering technique, we avoid using main memory for synchronization, we avoid costly memory access for synchronization variables, and we have very low latency overhead. Third, we organize the communication in a hierarchical manner. For a particular synchronization variable allocated in an NDP unit, the synchronization engine that is physically located at the same NDP unit with it is considered as the master synchronization engine for that particular variable. The master synchronization engine is responsible to globally coordinate synchronization for that specific variable. More specifically, NDP cores send their local synchronization request to their local synchronization engine that is located at the same NDP unit with them in order to request a particular synchronization variable. In the next level of communication, local synchronization engines communicate with the master synchronization engine by sending aggregated messages on behalf of all their local PIM cores in order to coordinate synchronization at a global level. This hierarchical communication is implemented via the corresponding support in the synchronization table and the corresponding information that we need to keep in the synchronization table. The local waiting list in each synchronization table entry includes one bit for each core within the NDP unit, and it is used for the local synchronization engine to keep track of which local NDP cores of the same NDP unit have requested a particular synchronization variable. And we also add a global waiting list, which includes one bit for each synchronization engine in the system, and it is used only by the master synchronization engine to keep track the engines of other NDP units that have globally requested a particular variable. And this proposed hierarchical design minimizes the expensive network traffic across the NDP units of the system. And the final key technique is that we implement an integrated overflow management scheme whenever the hardware synchronization resources are oversubscribed. More specifically, whenever the synchronization table is fully occupied and our hardware synchronization resources are oversubscribed, Synchron uses main memory as a fallback solution. In that scenario, The master synchronization engine directly falls back to main memory by issuing read or write requests to synchron specialized synchronization variable. We include inside the synchronization engine a set of counters, the indexing counters, which are indexed by the address of a synchronization variable, and they are used to indicate if a particular synchronization variable is currently serviced through main memory or not, based on if the value of the corresponding indexing counter is larger than zero or not. And if the synchronization table of a local synchronization engine overflows, we use specialized messages that are sent from the local engine to the master synchronization engine in order to hierarchically coordinate the synchronization through main memory in overflow scenarios. The proposed integrated hardware-only overflow management scheme effectively limits performance degradation under overflow scenarios and provides high programming ease since overflow scenarios are handled in a programmer-transparent manner. Synchron exposes to the user a high-level synchronization interface for the most widely used synchronization primitives, and these are the lock, barrier, semaphore, and condition variable primitives. In general, all these synchronization primitives hold the same principle. In order to implement synchronization, we basically need to keep some only a few metadata, and more specifically, a queuing list with that keeps that coordinates synchronization among the waiting cores, the waiting entities, and also we need to keep some information related to a condition that needs to be met in order to implement synchronization. Given that this synchronization metadata and information can be implemented using Synchron, Synchron can be easily extended to support other synchronization primitives like reader-writer logs or even monitors. So next, I will briefly describe Synchron operation for the log primitive. So let's assume a scenario where all the NTP cores of the system highly compete for the same lock variable. They are trying to acquire one particular lock variable. In this scenario, first, the NTP cores send local acquired messages to their local synchronization engines located at the same NTP unit with them. The local synchronization engines directly buffer these requests in their synchronization tables and update the local waiting list accordingly by setting the corresponding bit in the local waiting list in order to indicate that this particular NTP cores have just requested this particular lock variable. Then the local synchronization engine requests a lock from the master engine by sending one global lock acquired message. This message is an aggregated message on behalf of the local waiting cores. Therefore, we avoid sending multiple messages through the narrow expensive links that connect the NTP units of the system. Then the master synchronization engine updates the global waiting list in the synchronization table by setting the corresponding bit for the local synchronization engine that have just sent a particular synchronization request. First, the master engine grants the lock locally to the local NTP cores in order to serve all the local requests within the NTP unit. Each time, it resets the corresponding bits in the local waiting list accordingly. Based on the bits in the global waiting list, if the local waiting list is empty and there are all zero bits, the master engine will then grant the lock to the local synchronization engine of another NTP unit based on the global waiting list. In that scenario, it sends a global local grant message to the local engine of the other NTP unit. Then the local waiting list serve the, then the local synchronization engine serves all the requests of the local NTP cores within the same NTP unit, and each time it resets the corresponding bit in the local waiting list. When there are no other local requests from local NTP cores, meaning that the local waiting list becomes now empty, the local synchronization engine releases the corresponding synchronization table entry, and afterwards it sends an aggregated global lock release message to the master synchronization engine. The master synchronization engine resets the corresponding bit in the global waiting list in its local synchronization table. Given that both the global and the local waiting lists are now empty and there are no other pending requests at the global level, the master synchronization engine also releases the corresponding synchronization table entry. Let's look at a scenario where we have, in an overflow scenario, where we have all the synchronization tables to be fully occupied. In the overflow scenario, we have designed specialized overflow messages that are sent from the local to the master synchronization engine in order to indicate an overflow scenario and coordinate synchronization via main memory. Each time, the local engine and the master engine increase the corresponding indexing counter for that particular synchronization variable in order to indicate that this particular synchronization variable is serviced using the main memory. In order to coordinate synchronization via main memory, the master synchronization engine issues read and write requests to a specialized synchron variable. We have designed a specialized structure, which is called synchron var, in order to coordinate synchronization in overflow scenarios. As you can see, the synchron var also includes two main metadata information, which are a waiting list and some information related with the condition that needs to be met in order to synchronize. Then I will briefly describe synchron's benefits, both the performance and energy benefits that we can have. In our evaluation, we use ZSIM and RAMulator simulators, and we configure them to have four NTP units. Each of them has 16 in-order cores. For main memory, we use the HBM memory technology. And for synchron, we use Aladdin and Cacti in order to simulate the access latency to each component. We study three classes of applications. All of them are irregular applications, and they are very well suited for the NTP systems. More particularly, more specifically, we have evaluated 9 pointer chasing data structures, 6 graph processing workloads, and a time series analysis workload. In our evaluation, we have experimented with both a coarse grain and fine grain synchronization approach. In the first case, in the coarse grain solution, only one global lock protects all the shared data, and therefore all the cores highly compete. They have high competition and high contention in order to acquire that particular lock file. In the second case, in the fine grain locking approach, a large number of synchronization variables protects a small granularity of the shared data, and therefore leading to cores not to frequently compete for the same variables at the same time. So we have a low contention scenario. And also in our evaluation, we use the term synchronization intensity in order to refer to the ratio of synchronization over the other computation in the workload. As this ratio increases, meaning the synchronization latency affects more the total execution time, and we have higher synchronization costs in the workload. So we compare synchron with three different schemes. First, we have Central, which is a message passing scheme where only one dedicated NTP core on the whole system acts as server, a synchronization server, and coordinates synchronization among all NTP cores of the system. This synchronization server accesses variables through its memory hierarchy and communicates with the remaining client cores via a hardware message passing scheme. We also compare Synchron with Hire, which is a hierarchical software-based message passing scheme where one dedicated NTP core per NTP unit acts as server and coordinates synchronization. Synchronization server cores and the remaining client cores communicate with a hierarchical manner via a hardware message pass. And finally, we compare Synchron with an ideal scheme with zero performance overhead for synchronization. For a fair comparison between all schemes, we use the same number of client cores that execute the main workload, which is 15 NTP cores per NTP unit. In this slide, we demonstrate the performance for all comparison points in pointer testing data structure. In this plot, we vary the number of NTP cores in steps of 15, and each time we add one more NTP unit. And we make four key observations. First, the stack data structure exhibits high contention because all NTP cores compete for only one lock variable, and we have a very coarse-grained locking scenario. In these highly contested scenarios, the hierarchical schemes Hire and Synchron perform better by minimizing the expensive network traffic across the NTP units of the system. Second, we evaluate a hash table data structure that incurs a medium contention because different cores might work on different parts of the hash table. In medium contented scenarios, the hierarchical schemes perform better because they minimize the expensive network traffic across the NTP units of the system, and also they include multiple server cores that concurrently serve different requests and thereby increasing the execution parallelism. And third, we evaluate a very large linked list data structure that has fine-grained locking, fine-grained synchronization, and as a result, we have very low contention. In low-contention scenario, Synchron significantly outperforms the prior schemes because it minimizes the latency overhead due to direct buffering the synchronization variables in the proposed low-cost synchronization tables and significantly minimizing the latency cost by avoiding using main memory for synchronization. Fourth, we observe that when more fine-grained synchronization is used in the workload, Synchron even further outperforms the higher scheme. This is because it avoids an even higher number of memory access for synchronization thanks to its direct buffering capability to the proposed low-cost synchronization table. Overall, we conclude that Synchron achieves the highest throughput under all different contentious scenarios with diverse synchronization conditions. We also evaluate real-world applications such as graph processing workloads and a time series analysis workload. All these workloads include fine-grained synchronization, and therefore we have very low contention among the NTP cores. In such a workload, Synchron achieves significant performance benefits over prior schemes, and we observe that time series analysis is a synchronization intensive application because the ratio of synchronization over the other computation of the workload is very high. In synchronization intensive application, Synchron even further outperforms the prior message passing schemes as the synchronization portion is higher in the total execution time. Overall, we find that Synchron outperforms the prior best performing scheme by 1.23 times, and also it performs within 9.5% of the performance of an ideal scheme with zero overhead for synchronization. So we conclude that Synchron performs best across all real-world applications. So in this figure, we demonstrate the system energy achieved for the gas network and memory. In all real applications, Synchron provides high energy reductions over the prior message passing schemes, and also it incurs only 6.2 energy overhead, only 6.2% energy overhead over an ideal scheme, thanks to its hierarchical approach and direct buffering capability. In these experiments, we find that Synchron significantly improves the network energy consumption thanks to its hierarchical design, and also significantly improves the memory energy thanks to its direct buffering capability of the synchronization variables to the proposed synchronization table. And overall, we conclude that Synchron significantly reduces the system energy consumption in all real-world applications. In our analysis, we also compare all of these comparison points and schemes using different memory technologies. We find that Synchron's benefits are independent to the memory technology used, and its performance versus the ideal scheme only slightly varies across the different memory technologies because the synchronization tables never overflow, so we never use the main memory. And we find that Synchron benefits over prior schemes increases as the memory access latency becomes higher, because we avoid an even more expensive memory accesses for synchronization. For example, in the time series analysis workload, we can see that Synchron outperforms higher by 1.41 times when we use the HBM memory technology, and it outperforms higher by 2.49 times whenever we use the DDR4 memory technology, because it avoids an even more expensive memory accesses for synchronization. And overall, we conclude that Synchron is orthogonal to the memory technology used. And we also calculate the hardware cost of the proposed synchronization engines using Cacti and Aladdin. Here we observe that even with a larger technology node, the synchronization engine has much lower hardware costs, much lower area and power costs compared to a general purpose in order ARM Cortex-A7 core. And as a result, we conclude that our proposed hardware synchronization unit has very low area and power overheads to be integrated into the compute die of an NTP unit. Finally, we evaluate in our paper a large number of sensitivity studies, including various data placement techniques, various transfer latency on the links across the NTP units, the overflow management costs, and various sizes of the synchronization tables, and also many more configurations. The key takeaway of all these sensitivity studies is that Synchron is effective across a wide variety of different configurations. Let me now conclude my presentation. Synchronization is a major system challenge to retain all performance and energy benefits that near data processing systems provide. However, prior synchronization approaches are not suitable or efficient for NTP systems. And to this end, we have designed Synchron, the first end-to-end synchronization solution for NTP systems. Synchron consists of four key techniques. First, hardware support for synchronization acceleration in order to avoid the need for complex cache coherence protocols and expensive atomic operations. Second, direct buffering for synchronization variables to avoid using main memory for synchronization and minimize the latency cost. Third, hierarchical message passing communication to minimize the expensive network traffic across the NTP units of the system. And finally, an integrated hardware-only overflow management scheme to avoid costly fallback solutions and provide high programming ease under overflow scenarios. Our evaluation results show that synchron approaches the performance and energy of an ideal synchronization scheme with zero overhead. As a result, we conclude that synchron is highly efficient, low cost, easy to use, and generally supports many synchronization primitives to enable the widespread use and adoption of near data processing architectures. For more details on our work, we invite you to read our full HPCA 2021 paper. So thank you for your attention, and I'm happy to take any questions.
Thanks for the presentation, Christina. Maybe like we can wait for a while, like maybe a few seconds to see if there will be any questions on the live stream chat.
Sure.
Yeah, I don't see any questions at the moment. Okay, yeah, thanks again for the presentation. And I think this is it for today's lecture.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
Bye.